Hey everyone, this is Modine here, designer and creator of these do-it-yourself Bluetooth Pelican boom boxes. So I'm going to do a small short video on three different boom boxes, Pelican 1430, which is a 2.1 system with two-way speakers and a mono sub. It has features a 5-inch tang band sub. You can simply look at the video on the Pelican 1430. It's going to go head-to-head with the Sony SRS-X5, which is also a 2.1 system. It's 30 watts per channel. And then finally, the third Pelican box will be the Pelican 1200. It features 30 watts per channel and a two-way system with a passive radio in the back. So this is the giveaway 1200. I notified the winner. Who is a grand prize winner. I just haven't heard back from him yet, but hopefully soon we'll get this guy on the road and sent out to the winner here. And this is the Sony 2.1 system, 30 watts per channel. It's the SRS-X5. And then we have the Pelican 1430. This one has 100 watts per channel and 100 watt sub in it right now. So I'm using this pink noise generator. I'm going to play pink noise in the first half and then actually a tune and basically compare all three of them and see how they respond with this little app I have here. It's almost like an RTA, real-time analyzer app, and basically do a little bit of analysis on these guys here. So starting first is the pink noise generator. And by the way, what I've tried to do is set the overall SPL or sound pressure level the same. It's using a calibrated Dayton audio mic, which right out of the box I haven't done any kind of calibration, so things should be pretty even here. So the first thing would be pink noise, and pink noise would be from 20 hertz up to 22,000 hertz. First up is the Sony SRS-X5. You notice that I also have the sound feature on, so it has a little bit of a boost on the high end over here, between 10 and 20,000 hertz. It's relatively flat, has a nice little bass boost at the end, but it seems like it only goes down to about, starts to really roll off about between 60, maybe 65 hertz. Next up is the hi-fi boombox. 30 watts per channel, it's a Pelican 1200, and that features a two-way system, 4-inch aluminum cone woofers, and 5/8-inch silk dome tweeters. I also noticed too, it's a little flat too, relatively flat, but it has a little bit of a dip at 10,000 hertz. The bass seems to go down to about maybe between 50 and 60 hertz, right around there. And then a third boombox would be the Pelican 1430. You can tell that with the nice Dayton Audio 4-inch woofer, and then I believe that's a 3/4-inch Dayton Audio silk tone tweeter, it's really flat. It's going from the mid-range all the way to about, probably about 18-19,000 hertz. It's certainly beyond my hearing range. And the bass looks like it goes all the way down to, put that on pause, down to about, clearly it will produce some bass tones all the way down to about 35, 40 hertz with no problems there. Again, let's go over back to the Sony SRS-X5. Put it on pause there, and you can see it really starts to drop off between maybe 60 to 70, 75 hertz. But it's nice and fairly nice and flat coming down in the mid-range, and it has a tiny little bump in the treble range there because the sound feature is on. Let's turn off the sound feature. You can see the treble dropped off a little bit there. Turn the sound feature back on. Nice little boost up there. And then again, the Pelican 1200 hi-fi boombox. tell it's relatively flat, the mid-range, the bass is decent, doesn't really roll up at about 50, 60 hertz, but there's a little trouble spot, a little dip at 10,000 hertz. And then back to the Pelican 1430. Very nice and flat, all the way from the mid-range up to the high end, and nice little boost at the end. It's almost like a loudness feature. I'm gonna play some music. Stop this white pink noise. It gets a little annoying. Right, here's a tune, starting with the Pelican 1430. Going to the Hi-Fi 1200, Pelican 1200. So it looks like clearing responds all the way down to about 50 hertz. A little bit of a dip at 10,000 hertz. Going over to the Sony SRS-X5. Sony's relatively flat coming down. Nice little bass boost. Maybe in the 60 to 80 hertz range. Treble seems to be pretty clean. Back to the Pelican 1430. Clearly there's way more bass, much more range, more definition down there. Bass is nice and rich on the 1430. Look at the Sony. There's some bass, but it doesn't seem to be as full as the 1430. Go to the Pelican 1200. Bass seems to be a little bit better than the Sony. Going to the Sony SRS X5. Switching over to the Pelican 1200. Going to the Pelican 1430. Let's look at this white noise one more time. Here's the Sony. minus 20 dB overall. The screen capture. Relatively flat. It starts to drop off in the mid-range and then come up a little bit on the high end. It looks like it gets down to about 60 hertz over here. We go over to the Pelican 1200. The screen capture. Relatively flat, coming down, but there's a little bit of a dip. 10K. Goes back up and goes down to maybe 50, 60 hertz right there. And then it finally has to go back to the Pelican 1430. Obviously just a bigger boombox. More sound. Screen chapter. And yeah, it clearly goes down to 30, 35 hertz. Mid-range all the way to the high end is very flat. So that's very nice. Thanks for watching, guys.